Greetings to all the graduates of the class of 2020 of the city of Camden. Mayor Frank Moran here. Just wanted to congratulate you on this accomplishment and many accomplishments to come. Education is a key to success. Please go out, get your degrees, and come back to the city of Camden and continue to contribute to the city that's rising, your city, Camden, New Jersey.
Greetings to the class of 2020 of the Camden City School District. I am so proud of the class of 2020, as well as the teachers, coaches, and families who have guided you along the way. This school year presented many challenges, and you have overcome each and every one of them with style and grace. As a district, we have overcome so much this year. If you recall, in November, we witnessed and survived a violent act during the Camden-Pleasantville football game. During these moments of fear, we protected one another, and several students and staff emerged as heroes. We experienced the disappointing end to our Camden High basketball season and the realization many seniors would not complete their final season of spring sports in any of our Camden High schools. We lost our beloved school board president of over 20 years, Mrs. Martha F. Wilson. We are still experiencing a global pandemic that derailed our normal school schedules, prom, and other celebratory milestones. And the recent murder of George Floyd shook many of us to our very cores. It also caused us to rise up, to listen to one another across racial lines, and to protect one another. Individually, you have all persevered through your own obstacles. Every time you emerge stronger and better than before. For every obstacle we faced, we still have much to celebrate. And some of those points of celebration are, our graduation rate continues to rise. The fact that many of you received scholarships for academics and sports to attend your first choice schools shows that you continue to rise. Despite obstacles, Tiger Nation roared back as Woodrow Wilson High School brought home a football state championship win. You continue to rise. Despite our world being turned upside down, you all remained focused. You all rose above the challenges and emerged as the brilliant leaders we knew you were. While I can't begin to imagine all of the emotions you have experienced over the past months, I want to take this time to assure you that the disappointment of not being able to celebrate in person today will pass, and the emotions and memories that will remain will be ones of joy, resilience, and empowerment. Graduation is a monumental achievement under any circumstances. Graduating this year is really special. This graduating class is a part of so much history. All of your experiences have helped you grow up faster than some generations and have prepared you to conquer future obstacles. There is so much power that rests in your hands, and I know that you will use it to help each other, to help your family, and to help the community continue to rise. I am proud of you all and can't wait to see and hear what you accomplish in the next chapter of your lives. So congratulations to the class of 2020 of the Camden City School District. Keep making yourselves proud, keep making your families proud, and keep making the city of Camden proud. Congratulations, you've earned this special day.
Greetings, I'm your brother, Brother Minister Wasim Muhammad, School Board President of the Camden City School District. I want to first say congratulations to the class of 2020. I want to let you know how proud I am of you and all of the graduates here this year upon a very, very exciting and different year, you know, where most of our young people's education was kind of interrupted by, you know, the pandemic and some of the uprisings that we see going around the country dealing with systemic racism. But you are the highlight of the year. You are graduating and about to enter into the world. And we are so proud of you that you can accomplish and still succeed amongst anything that happens to you, that you can keep going on. So that is a moment in time that you will never forget. And I know what the Creator has put in you has made you able to succeed. So when you do continue to succeed, come back to your city and make your city a clean and safe place to live. Congratulations.
On behalf of Dr. Charles E. Brim, Medical Arts High School, I would like to extend a warm welcome to Superintendent Ms. Katrina McCombs, distinguished guests, medical arts staff, family, friends, and most importantly, the class of 2020. My heartfelt thanks and congratulations to all of the parents, guardians, family, and friends of the class of 2020 who have helped in any way to get their graduate to this point in their life. To the class of 2020, what a year to be graduating. The events of the last few months have rocked the world, demonstrating the notion that life can truly change at any time. One moment, we're planning your prom and graduation, and then your world came to a screeching halt as a result of a global pandemic. And although the image those words paint could be describing the plot to this summer's biggest movie, they represent the very real situation that you have had to deal with. In the final stretch of your high school career, you have had to quickly adjust to a new normal that is anything but normal. Now, our day-to-day conversations are fraught with words and phrases like pandemic, quarantine, and social distancing. Prior to the recent monumental events, these words served a more theoretical purpose, perhaps as terms you may have studied in your health class, never with the notion that these words would be inextricably intertwined with our daily dialogue. But now, here we are. And even though this is not how we envisioned celebrating the class of 2020, what I do know is that the how of celebrating you is not as important as the why. So why? Graduation is a day that you have had excitedly circled on your calendars for quite some time. Your graduation represents the culmination of hours upon hours of hard work and dedication. Your graduation symbolizes the end of your high school journey, but not the end of the relationships you have developed along the way. We are celebrating you because despite living in tumultuous times, class of 2020, you surpassed your goals and you made your Brim family unbelievably proud. Allow me to brag a little. Did you know that 40 of our seniors have been accepted to over 60 colleges and universities? Did you know our seniors received a grand total of $1.2 million in academic and athletic scholarships? Did you know 40% of our seniors received full rides to four-year universities? Way to go, class of 2020. These statistics are amazing and prove that Brim's class of 2020 embraces change and thrives under all sorts of strange circumstances. You are resilient and capable. As the principal of Brim, I have been reflecting and want to tell you how I feel about you. I feel admiration for the fact that you have risen to the challenge in the face of these strange times. Sympathy for the fact that you have lost a prom, a traditional graduation, and in some cases, loved ones. Respect for the fact that you have displayed tenacity, flexibility, and cooperation. We touched upon the why we are celebrating you. Now, some tips to move forward in your journey. First, keep an open mind. If something seems like it will be boring, give it a chance. If something seems like it will be too difficult, challenge yourself. Next, use your resources, people, classmates and professors, co-workers and bosses are there to help you. Lean on them. Keep on top of your work. Don't put things off until the last minute. Don't let assignments pile up. The stress mounts when you wait until the last minute. Get there to class or to work on time, or even better, early. Remember what they say, the early bird catches the worm. Be able to adapt. You never know how or when the world will change again. Learn to embrace change. Be kind. Most people have completely forgotten what happened during their high school graduation. What songs were sung, who spoke, and anything else of significance. I guarantee you will not forget your graduation and why we are celebrating you. Now go and make us proud, as you have the opportunity to capitalize on becoming the next greatest generation. You have the opportunity to make a difference. When you see injustice, do your best to be a force for positive change. Always help those in need of help and give your voice to the voiceless. You should never be silent. Go forward and be the change you want to see. You can and must be a part of this change. Don't let this opportunity pass you by without being prepared yourself. You have the potential, the determination, and intelligence to fulfill that obligation. Get it done.
Welcome, Superintendent McCombs, Advisory Board, Principal McCrina, and the Class of 2020. Thank you all for being a part of our celebration during these trying times. My name is Dinesha Marie Holmes, and I'm this year's Class of 2020's salutatorian for Dr. Charles E. Brim Medical Arts High School. 4 years ago, on our first day at Brim, we found out we had class advisors, Mr. Blaho and Ms. Luke, and we were now the Class of 2020, the class with perfect vision. We decorated the Christmas tree and hallway and beat all the upperclassmen in the competition. That was our first sign that we were on the right path. I stand here and think to myself how proud I am of every one of you for being here today and gaining this wonderful achievement. I'm happy I was able to take this four-year journey with all of you. The crazy times, like when all the funny signs played in exposures with Dr. Fine that made us laugh, when we all went to that trip freshman year and took all those group photos together. I am thankful for all the teachers here at Brim who have taught me the learning skills I need to begin my journey into college. But I want to acknowledge a couple of teachers that I feel like made a mark during my high school experience, and some of my classmates may feel the same. I want to thank Ms. Johnson for always being there for us when needed. She is a great supporter. I want to thank Mr. Chavarrier for having such a great heart and always having a smile on his face when we stepped into his class. He never seemed to be down. I want to thank Mr. Abram for being so hard on us. I want to thank Ms. Abram for helping us with anything we needed and for helping us with our beautiful yearbook. I want to thank Ms. Jones for helping us through our senior year with our colleges and making sure everything was getting done. Last but not least, I want to thank Ms. Luke for being my mentor and helping me on the right path for my future. Chow House definitely had a great impact on my life and have molded the directions of my future. The food bank for community pets, the wellness clinic, and the experience of assisting in surgical procedures has given me the perfect start on my journey to become a veterinarian. We are not the same 14-year-olds that walked through Brim's doors that very first day of school freshman year. We have matured, grown, and learned to work independently and how to use our resources. The world outside is not the same as 4 years ago, and we have learned to navigate our way through the changes. It's been an honor being your vice president, and I wish you all the best in your next journey. And remember, this is the start of a new beginning for us all. Good luck, Class of 2020.
I would like to welcome Madam Superintendent, the Advisory Board, Principal Macrina, families, and the Class of 2020. My fellow brothers and sisters, although 2020 hasn't been the year we've expected it to be, we prospered when others believed we were too foolish to accomplish what we have in the end. We made it like we said we would, but this isn't the end of any of our journeys, instead, new beginnings. If there's anything you get out of this speech, remember, everything happens for a reason. I grew up in a low-income household, raised by a single mother, as I'm sure some of you can relate, and the things I saw, felt, and experienced shape the woman that stands before you. I am strong, creative, independent, intelligent, and your class valedictorian. I'm even on my way to becoming a veterinarian. At a young age, I was a victim of sexual assault, and at the time, I was a weird girl at school who nobody wanted to be next to. I was so out of place and scared. I just assumed it was okay for people to make fun of me and really put me down. As I grew, I realized I depended on others to make me feel validated in society because that's what I observed from everybody else. I found my voice when I stumbled upon my passions, taekwondo and art, and with that I was able to find balance within myself to express my deep emotions that I couldn't explain. During high school, my support system was stronger than ever by people like my aunt, my mom, my significant other, my class advisors, Ms. Jones, and the staff at Broom. They polished my traits that made me excited to speak my mind and become my own leader. I used my voice to become a class valedictorian, thank you Mr. Blejo and Ms. Luke, and president of Chahan, which introduced me to my love for animals. I never realized that one trip to Georgia could have such an impact on my life's journey. Chahan brought other characteristics I never knew existed. I never imagined that I would be interviewed live on Good Morning America and International Leaders, or be a spokesperson for a group, leader, and organizer of events involving hundreds of people and animals that depended on me. The growth in my individuality has welcomed opportunities in my life that I have never thought I'd receive, also show my potential. Who would have thought that the little weird girl that was bullied accomplished all that she did? I feel the same way about our current issues. We as a minority group were shamed and beaten to not speaking our truth. Now, we are becoming aware of our ancestral past and the reality of this world. People will try to stifle our futures and lives because of the color of our skin, but we will not be silenced. We have demonstrated that we are able to display our feelings and express our thoughts in a peaceful but powerful way. Regardless, we will be heard and there will be change. We just must remain consistent. I want to encourage each and every one of you to remember who you were 4 years ago. Remember who the person sitting next to you was 4 years ago. See how much we have grown. The person sitting next to you has helped you in your journey, has aided in developing your very being. We are young adults, the class of 2020, ready to conquer this world. To the class that is resilient, competitive, and persistent, take those traits with you to your journey after high school because we are the next big thing. I know we will prosper during these times together. Love, peace, and happiness to us all. God bless.
Edwin Coleman is a native of Camden, New Jersey, and an alum of Dr. Charles E. Brim Medical Arts High School. After graduating with the class of 2007, Edwin went to Duke University to earn his bachelor's degree in International Comparative Studies and Cultural Anthropology. Upon completing his undergraduate degree, Edwin moved to Cape Town, South Africa for a year to conduct research on education policy issues affecting underserved South African Township students. He then moved to Morocco for 2.5 years to serve as a youth development specialist in the United States Peace Corps. Edwin also worked as a federal investigator of workplace discrimination crimes with the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission in Philadelphia before pursuing his master's degrees in public policy at Princeton University and international education policy at Harvard University. Edwin now works as an associate at McKinsey & Company, and he is truly delighted to share a celebratory message with the class of 2020.
Hello and congratulations to the class of 2020. I am thrilled and honored to be celebrating your high school graduation from my alma mater, Dr. Charles E. Brim Medical Arts High School. Ostensibly, this ceremony is a celebration of the high school diplomas you all have earned, which is no small feat and must absolutely be celebrated. However, it's important for us to get clear on what exactly we're celebrating today, which in my view is far more than the grades and diplomas you've earned. Today, we are celebrating the resilience you displayed as you navigated obstacles and overcome challenges that may have stood in the way of this moment. Today, we are celebrating the love and support from your family, friends, teachers, and mentors whose belief in you made the difference on days when your belief in yourself was waning. Today, we are celebrating the passions you've discovered, the skills and talents you've honed, the friendships you've made, and perhaps most importantly, the knowledge you've gained. In a 2005 graduation address at Princeton University, the late Toni Morrison brilliantly said, quote, "I'm a believer in the power of knowledge and the ferocity of beauty." So from my point of view, your life is already artful, waiting, just waiting for you to make it art, end quote. I share Morrison's point of view about the class of 2020 that's educated and beautiful. Yet at the same time, I recognize how difficult it must be to imagine using your knowledge and beauty to make your life art during a time of great turmoil and unrest in our society. You find yourselves graduating at a time when a global pandemic has brought life as we knew it to a grinding halt, a time when our economy increasingly benefits the richest among us and leaves the most vulnerable unprotected and unsupported, a time when socio-political chasms are growing and the dysfunction in Washington continues to soar to globally embarrassing levels. And you are graduating at a time when racial tensions have risen to a boiling point as communities of color across the country grow tired of systemic and institutionalized oppression that far too often cuts life short, limits liberty, and inhibits the pursuit of happiness. Perhaps you are wondering, how then can you make your life art under these conditions? I certainly do not have all the answers to that question, though I do have a few points of wisdom that I hope will inspire the art you create along your journey after high school. The three things I will speak about are, one, how to deal with life's uncertainties, two, the power of practicing self-compassion, and three, the importance of living your life according to your values, all of which are principal learnings from my very recent intensive treatment for OCD. Before I jump into those points, you did not mishear me. Yes, I do have OCD. I do not fit the stereotype of what most people believe OCD to be. No, I do not check the locks on my doors 100 times before I leave my house every day. No, I do not have pens that are perfectly aligned on my desk. Truth is, there are over 900 flavors of OCD, and I have just a handful of them. One flavor in particular that I struggle with the most is perfectionism. Although a lot of people who are hard workers and detail-oriented often refer to themselves as perfectionists, trust me when I say that OCD perfectionism is far more debilitating than what the average person experiences. For me, OCD looks like spending 10 of my waking hours every day incessantly thinking about the typo that I sent in an email or an awkward interaction that I had with someone 2 months ago. I convince myself over the course of this obsessive thinking that these mistakes are so big that I'm going to lose my job and all of my friends and loved ones are going to abandon me because of my imperfections. You see, in perfectionism OCD, there is no such thing as a small mistake without catastrophic consequences. And at its worst, OCD has negatively affected my productivity at work and has led to severe social withdrawal, anxiety, depression, and suicidal ideation. Luckily for me, the lessons I've learned in OCD treatment have helped me to gradually return to a more fulfilling life. And I believe that these lessons are relevant for people without OCD and especially relevant for the class of 2020. Or perhaps not relevant at all. I don't actually know for sure. And this lack of clarity and certainty brings us to my first point, that life's uncertainty is neither a friend nor a foe. It just is. So embrace the what if. What if there was a typo in my email? What if I didn't lock the car door? What if the person I spoke to thought I was awkward? In the OCD brain, these questions are never ending, and they often lead to a wide range of compulsions, such as avoidance, rumination, checking. And these compulsions are excessive and disruptive to our lives. People without OCD also struggle with what-if questions, but to a less disruptive extent. Perhaps some recent what-ifs for you have been, what if I don't make any friends at college? What if I don't become class president? For me, the what-if question is, what if this speech is terrible and the class of 2020 hates me? The lesson here is to not allow the possibility of the worst outcome to keep you from going after the things that you desire. Do not avoid what seems scary or challenging because you can't know for certain that things will work out in your favor. I do not know for certain how people may perceive this speech, but I'm sharing it anyway, just as it's incredibly important that you all pursue your dreams no matter where they may lead and regardless of the potential outcome. To make uncertainty your enemy is to remain afraid of it your whole life. And life will rarely give you the certainty you desire, so you may as well embrace it and all the range of possibilities before you as an opportunity to learn something new rather than an outcome to be feared. There will be times when what you did not want to happen will happen. You receive an exam back and the grade is not what you were expecting. You applied for an internship and it doesn't work out. You shared your commencement speech and the graduating class didn't like it. In these times when the road of uncertainty ends at our worst nightmare, remember to practice self-compassion. In OCD treatment, this lesson is vital because the road to better health is full of painful pitfalls that require self-compassion to overcome. Trust the perfectionist. No one's life can be perfect, so expect to experience very difficult pitfalls ahead. When they arrive, remember to be gentle with yourself. Forgive yourself for the mistakes. Grant yourself time to heal and give to yourself the love and support that you give to a dear friend. And most importantly, believe that you have what it takes to stand back up again. And when you do stand up, act in accordance to your highest values. This last lesson really hits home for me because when my OCD was at its worst, I had completely lost sight of the things I valued most. My family, my friends, my education, public service. Part of my treatment involved reminding myself of these values so that I could set my goals on returning to them. For you, it may not be OCD, but rather a person or a situation, perhaps even an institution that may be causing you to lose sight of your values. But in order to return your focus to your values, you must first know what they are. I encourage you to spend some time this summer thinking about what values you have and how you plan to act on those values right now. If you value education, you don't have to wait on an institution to teach you something new. You can educate yourself right now. If you value justice, you don't have to wait for permission to raise your voice. Raise it right now. If you value creating new things, you don't have to wait for someone else to come along for you to start innovating. You can start with whatever you have right now. Start right now, as you are with what you have. Because if you can't tell by the news, our world really needs the art you plan to create with your life right now. We need young people like yourselves, who will stare uncertainty in the face and act anyway, who will strengthen themselves and others with compassion during difficult times, who will live according to their highest values, regardless of the conditions of the world around them. I have been fortunate enough to have lived and worked around the world and to have learned at some of the world's most prestigious universities. And although I cannot be certain about most things, there is one thing I know for sure, and it is that our students from Camden, New Jersey, have the knowledge and the beauty to create art out of their lives that the world needs and has never seen before. Class of 2020, remember to lean into uncertainty when you're afraid. Remember to practice self-compassion when you fall down. And most importantly, remember to continue to live according to your highest values when you stand back up. Your lives matter. Your lives are already artful. Now it is time for you to go out and create art. Thank you.
Congratulations on this monumental accomplishment in your lives. Over the past 4 years, despite every obstacle put in front of you, we have watched you grow and develop into independent adults. You are already well aware of the many challenges and obstacles you will continue to face as you move into the next phase of your lives. And while they may feel overwhelming and demoralizing at times, just know that you can and will persevere. You made it this far. There's no reason why you can't go further. It's no shock to tell you America is a country that is completely divided right now, and it's your turn to proudly lead by example and demonstrate everything you've learned over the last 12 years about civil rights, women's rights, anti-fascism, equality to people of color, the equality of the LGBTQ community, and freedom of religious belief. We are asking you to take the next step in generational efforts to extinguish systemic inequality that is clearly still glorified in pockets of the country.
We as teachers have demonstrated various leadership styles and methods to navigate through life. We as your advisors guided and hopefully assisted along your journey at Brim. This experience has been very emotional for all of us. Different principals, different teachers with different teaching styles, and some classes with no teachers. Yet you learned to adapt and maneuver through your paths. It was homecoming this year. We were pleasantly surprised how all you came together and pulled off a great production, proving to us things were beginning to gel.
Moving forward, you can make an impact in any number of ways, but the most effective includes standing up for and protecting one another, providing for your families, and continuing to educate yourself long after that last bell rings. Your senior year might have been cut short, but the rest of your life is truly just beginning. We love and respect you all and hope you always remember these feelings of strength, determination, and pride that you feel in this moment, because these emotions are a result of your achievements and they are well deserved.
Pandemic was a freshman vocabulary health word during medicine timeline. I told you that it would never occur in your or my lifetime. I was wrong. We may not have a normal graduation, but you are not a normal class. This graduation is not like any other. We are privileged to have been your advisors, and we will always remember your class resilience and determination.
You are the class of 2020, and you have perfect vision.
Congrats!
Hello, I am Mrs. Hall, the guidance counselor at Brim Medical Arts High School. I'm going to share with you the awards and scholarship this fabulous class of 2020 has received. First name is Gerwith Arceveda Rutgers Camden Full Ride. Alani Osgona Ramapo Full Ride. And also the Camden Foundation Scholarship for $2,500. Ariana Boyer, Remarkable Grads, $1,000 for 4 years. Naya Bush, Rowan, Camden, Full Ride. Jaya Devine, Rutgers, Camden, Full Ride. Franciella Guzman, Rowan, Camden, Full Ride. Dinesia Holness, Ramapo College, Full Ride. And also Remarkable Grads, $1,000 for 4 years. Arcadia Jimenez, Rowan Camden, Full Ride. Taylor Morrell, Remarkable Grads, $1,000 for 4 years. Crystal Montero, Thomas Jefferson University, Full Ride, and also the Battleship Scholarship for $1,000. Byron Mosley, he gets the Camden Foundation Scholarship for $2,500. Also, the Remarkable Grads for $1,000 for 4 years, at the OES Corinthian Chapter 1, a scholarship for $100 for books. Nina Nguyen, Rutgers Camden, full ride. Dion Moya Pagan, Rowan Camden, full ride. Precious Riley, Rutgers Camden, full ride. Abigail Rivera Mercado, Gettysburg College, full ride, and also the Camden Foundation Scholarship for $2,500. Jordan Sweet, Camden Foundation Scholarship for $2,500. Janiah Taylor, Fairley Dickerson University, full ride. Teresa Troutman, Bloomfield College, full ride. Katara Vaughn, Monmouth University, full ride, Camden Foundation, and also the Camden Foundation Scholarship for $2,500. Tariq Austin Cave, University of Miami, full ride. Katara Vaughn, Monmouth University, full ride, and also the Camden Foundation Scholarship for $2,500. Again, I want to tell the entire class of 2020 that I'm proud of you, and again, congratulations, and I wish you the best of luck.
Now introducing to you the class of 2020, Brim Medical Arts, beginning with the top 10. Abigail Rivera Mercado.
Dinesia Holness.
Christine Chukwuemere.
Dion Moye Pagan.
Gerwith Acevedo.
Nina Nguyen.
Adira Mackin.
Jordan Sweet.
Maya Matthews.
Janaya Taylor.
Tyreek Austin Cave.
Alani Escon.
Elijah Boone.
Ariana Boyer.
Naya Rios Bush.
Kayasia Clayton.
Jaya Devine.
Amir Frazier.
Javier Gonzalez.
Luis Gonzalez.
Francie Alice Guzman Melendez.
Christopher Hall.
Jalen Borzi.
Arcadia Jimenez.
Gianni Jordan.
Kevin Leung.
Ayana Lugo.
Angel Medina.
Taylor Merrill.
Crystal Montero.
Byron Mosley.
Knowledge Perez.
Precious Jewel Riley.
Luis Sanchez.
Tiana Smith.
Tatiana Tatum.
Raymond Torres Soto.
Teresa Trout.
Katara Long.
Sharon Walters.
Graduates, please stand. By the power vested in me as the State District Superintendent for the Camden City School District, I hereby affirm that the senior class of 2020 has met the graduation requirements on this day as set forth by the New Jersey Department of Education. To the graduating class, I hereby confer upon you high school diplomas with all rights and privileges thereunto appertaining. At this time, please move your tassels from right to left, signifying the completion of your high school career. Congratulations and best wishes on future success.
Mama call, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hatin', say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. They was never friendly, yeah. Now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it, yeah. I'm surrounded 20 bad, yeah. But they didn't know me last year, yeah. Everyone wanna act like they important, but all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom. Yeah, yeah. If you be with winning, put your lighters to the sky. How could I make sense when I got millions on my mind? Coming with it, I just put it to the side. Bought a sense of baby, they could see it in my eyes. My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hatin', say we changing, look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
I was patient, yeah. Oh, I was patient, hey, oh. Now I can scream that we made it. Now everywhere I go, they say congratulations. Young nigga, graduation, yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Never old being frank. Big rings, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Paso big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl, caught a hoe. Get in the rows. Top flow lifestyle. Top Hunter and Post. Malone, I got a play on my phone. You know what I'm on. Huncho Houdini is gone.
My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hatin', say we changin', look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
Do you ever feel like a plastic bag drifting through the wind, wanting to start again? Do you ever feel this so paper thin, like a house of cards, one blow from caving in? Do you ever feel already buried deep, 6 feet under screens but no one seems to hear a thing? Do you know that there's still a chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you? You just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just on the night, shoot across the sky. wasted space. Your original cannot be replaced. If you only knew what the future holds. After a hurricane comes a rainbow. Maybe a reason why all the doors are closed, so you could open one that leads you to the perfect road. Like a lightning bolt, your heart will glow, and when it's time you know, you just gotta ignite the light and let it shine. Just own the night like the 4th of July. 'Cause baby you're a firework.
Chit chit.